The turkeys react to the robot differently depending on how many times they've seen it. When they're younger, they get very curious about the robot. They'll just get very, very close and peck at it, which is fine for the robot, fine for the birds. I have a robotics background and grew up in the Midwest, always liked farming. Thinking through where could a robot really fit in and help, I met up with turkey farmers that said, like, yes, please do this. We thought, we can do robots, let's do this robot.
So Redwing is one of the earliest towns in Minnesota. It was a river town that was the last stop on the river. So it developed really early and had a lot of industry. But they're very old companies. So the question is, like, how do we produce another one of those companies every 10 to 20 years? Redwing Ignite is a community center that's focused on innovation. We hosted an ag tech challenge last year. You know, we invited people within the region to come down and pitch their best ag idea.
Most ag tech approaches innovation from the biological side. That's not my skill set. It seemed like there was a lot of opportunity for modernization and new technology in this space. I ended up submitting the poultry house robot idea and winning first place, which gave me enough money to buy a robot and actually start testing and working with local farmers.
When someone comes up with an idea or wants to try something new, I'm usually pretty open to letting them work on it. So there's lots of uses for this robot. The primary need now is just there's a shortage of labor, and having an extra set of eyes and ears, whether they're human or artificially intelligent eyes and ears on the farm, could be of great value to let our human employees concentrate on what they can do best and let the robot concentrate on some of the more menial tasks.
Yeah, so a farmer would typically use the robot checking in, like in an email or something. The robot will say, hey, I patrolled early in the morning. This is what I found. Here's a map of the barn, and here's where I found any issues in the barn. If you have 6 poultry barns, that's an hour of your day just going in and out of barns. So it'll allow them to prioritize which barns they check in what order. Yeah, right now we're developing the actual mechanisms to accomplish the physical tasks we want the robot to do. It can turn in place, it has good traction. As it drives around in the barn, it can turn the litter, which improves litter conditions, which improves the health of the birds. There's localization devices, so the robot knows where it is in the barn. Several different types of cameras, so the robot can see everything, and even thermal imaging for detecting if a bird has a fever. If a human can drive the robot around in the barn remotely and do what we want it to do, then we can probably train a neural network or some other machine learning system to control the robot. The robot is essentially just another IoT device that's connected with a bunch of other sensors in the barn. Getting internet access at poultry barns has been a real challenge, but it is really the enabling factor to be able to build a robot out in a rural community quickly.
Before you can be a smart city, you have to have a smart infrastructure. Obviously, broadband would be the first of that infrastructure that's needed. Redwing was forward-thinking, and they implemented gigabit broadband a handful of years ago. So as a town of 16,000, we have gigabit broadband. Once we have that foundation in place, we can discover new technologies.
The first component is making sure that we have our technology base available to the people who want to use it. But there's a second piece, which is around activating the entrepreneurs, encouraging them to take risks, systematizing how they do it. This is not the kind of support you're going to get in Silicon Valley.
The model in rural communities has to be different. In urban settings, you have the density that you need. You have the people, talent, and resources needed to have those collisions of new innovative ideas. In rural communities, you have to force that density. You have to bring people together, thought leaders together, students together, technologists together, and really try to solve problems using technology.
They gave us the connections we needed. They connected us with the farmers themselves, who helped really prioritize what should this robot actually do for these people. The birds are healthier, the farmers happier. We are years ahead of where we could have hoped to be without them.